Since I've been doing this YouTube thing for about 3 years, I've noticed that there's a few comments that come up more than once. So I figured I'd just take a few minutes to answer some of them so that when they come up again, I can just point back to this video. And the one comment, the question that comes up the most is about this power supply here. What is it? Where did I get it? Where can you get one? Stuff like that. So let's just quickly go to eBay and I'll show you what it is first of all. So what it is this, and here's the search term to find them, B3606. But it is basically a buck converter, 3 amp, 0 to 36 volts. Let's just click on one of these. So it can handle between 6 and 40 volts in and give you 0 to 36 volts out and up to 3 amps on the output side. So, and some of the features of it that made me choose to use this thing is you can set it to both constant current and constant voltage on the output. And then there's the 4-digit LED, and it's all settable there. So that's basically what it is. There is a big brother version of it, the 3806, which is 38 volts out, and that one has the same input, 10 to 40 volt, well, a little bit higher, but up to 6 amps on the output side. And everything else is pretty much the same. So this guy, I just happened to print out the specs and put it on the back so they don't have to remember it all the time. But basically, it came with a set of screw terminals in the input and a set on the output. However, through use, the ones on the output fell off. They just broke right at the little screw terminal base. And at the time, I didn't have any of these in stock as spare parts. I do now. You've seen those in the mailbox, mailbags. So what I ended up doing is just put this 3-pin JST connector on there and just soldered it in place with the middle pin out. And then I made up a couple of connectors that I can just plug onto the output. So this one just goes to wires, which I've got going onto these 3-conductor WAGO connectors. But I've also got this one for USB for when I'm testing USB stuff or just want to power something and I want to see what the current draw is and how much and be able to set the current limit just in case I don't trust it. So I'm powering it from a laptop power brick, just a standard laptop power brick like this one, which happens to be 19 volts and 4.7 amps output. So I could go up to a 40 volt input, which means I could probably put two of these in series, actually, if I needed to get higher than that 19 volts. Right now, with the 19 volt input, I can get about 17 and a half or 18 volts out of this thing, roughly, which 99% of the time, that's all I need. Yeah, something else that's come up surprisingly often, and it's not something that just I use, it's this stuff, which I've used to hold stuff in place on a board when I'm soldering it, or just to hold some LED strips in place temporarily, or pretty much anything temporarily. It's called, well, the real product is called Blue Tack. This stuff came from a dollar store for the usual dollar store price. You can also get it in other colors, but blue seems to be the most common one. And it's just a putty that you work it a little bit, and as you work it and it warms up, it gets stickier. And then you can stick stuff to it and it'll kind of hold it. Its real intention, what's designed for, is for like temporarily holding up posters and stuff like that. But it does a really good job for soldering. The only downside is that when it gets warmer, it gets softer. So you have to let it cool off a little bit after you finish soldering. Otherwise, it'll be really goopy and sticky. Another question that I get surprisingly often is about my camera and recording setup here and whatnot. So for the first, 30 or 40 videos or thereabouts, the first year roughly, I was shooting everything using this Sanyo camcorder, just a little tiny little camcorder. It claims to be able, and it can do HD 1920 by 1080. I don't shoot in that. I do everything at 720 and 30 frames per second. 30 frames per second because I'm just not moving fast enough for 60 frames per second to make any difference, really. So this is what I used for the first bunch of videos. And I had it mounted just up there, just above my right shoulder, shooting down onto the bench. I'll switch over to it and kind of this angle here. Now I'm going to move it right beside my existing camera. As I switch between the two of them, you'll notice that the camcorder, it's fully zoomed out, and that's what it's showing. So that's why that's the main reason why I switched to using what I'm using now, which is a phone. And actually, this is the second phone that I've used for this. It's just a Samsung, what is this? This is an S8, I think. I was using a Note 4 for a couple of years almost, but it finally just completely died. So there's where the phone is normally sat, just in this selfie stick holder thing. It's just bolted onto the bottom of the railroad, and that's just sitting pretty much at my forehead level, so I can just glance up and make sure I'm in shot and technical stuff like that. But then off to my right is my computer, which is, well, there's a video I did about it last year sometime. I'll put a link up there somewhere. It's one that I literally found on the side of the road and threw together with some pieces, parts that I found lying around. This microphone is, I've started using it a couple months ago, and there's a video back there about that, and there's the audio interface from a pawn shop. There's the original microphone that I'd been using for a long time on just a little selfie stick boom, and that's actually where I had the camcorder mounted, just on that, shooting down over my shoulder. So nothing fancy. People that say you need $1 million worth of stuff to do YouTube, bullshit. So from that position there, you need, see, I've got lots of stuff just out of shot so that I can grab it quickly, including an assortment of meters, bunch of breadboards, some old projects and stuff like that down there. And then that's just a scrap box down there with parts of failed projects, stuff to tear apart, whatnot. Some old model railroad stuff. And I think I've showed you some of my storage stuff before. Critically important. More storage, power bricks. And then the railroad continues on around this way. Although, every time I ignore it, it turns into a storage space, which is not ideal. There's a tripod with another selfie stick phone holder thing on it that I sometimes use, often when I'm at the other workbench out in the laundry room there. And future model railroad kits. And you remember that from a month or two back. Oh yeah, another question. What's on my mug? It's usually asked about this mug. What does it say? There you go. I'm not going to pronounce it because my French pronunciation is horrible, which is another question somebody's asked. How many language, or what languages do I speak? I speak English mediocrely, and so I can sort of understand cereal box French, but that's about it. Anyway, there's the translation into English. For those of you who are equally bad at French as I am. Went to a concert these guys put on with their jazz band configuration, which was excellent. They've also got a sort of a rock band configuration in addition to the standard military band configuration that one would expect. They're on YouTube as well. So what other questions did I jot down here? Oh yeah, am I ever going to show my face? The channel is about what I'm doing, not who I am. So another question about buying things and you don't ever see me using them. Well, that's not really true. And one of the things why I do buy, one of the reasons why I do buy all that stuff, all this cheap stuff on eBay, first of all, it's so cheap, how can you not? But more importantly is a thing that I think Jimmy Dresta stated best when he made this poster here. And that came up fairly recently when Marcel had contacted a few people to build these subscriber counter things. He challenged me to do it in a comment where we were both on the same video somewhere. And I sat down that evening and I had everything I needed to do it in stock. I didn't have to order anything. I didn't have to wait. I could just sit down and have the fun of building it. So that's why. So I do have lots of stuff in the mailbag queue. So I'm not going to run out of that anytime soon. Even if China closes their borders or Canada closes the borders to China or anything else happens. And well, let's take a look around actually. So this is four different sets of things, projects, I guess, that came out of stuff that I already had in stock. This thing came from an eBay purchase. Actually, let's look over in the tools. This screwdriver, this solder wick, this flux, and this flux, and these spudgers, and those tweezers, and these wire cutters. Now, a lot of this stuff came from, and that's stuff that I use on a regular basis. What else? The magnifiers that you see me use regularly. This shitty solder, which I'm probably not going to use for anything except for maybe weights. And a lot of this stuff, this meter that I use on a regular basis, the Kapton tape, you know, a lot of this stuff does get used. You may not see it in every video, but it does get used. The cheap Beku Fake-Heiko soldering station over here. It turned out to be a really good purchase for super cheap, and I'm not too concerned about it. If it fails somehow, because it was cheap. Oh yeah, there was I asked the guys on Patreon if they had any specific questions, and there were some joke questions. That's where the "am I ever going to show my face" question came from. The other one was asking about my background and whatnot. Some people have suggested that I'm an electronic engineer, electrical engineer. I'm not. My training is as a technician, not as an engineer. It was a relatively short course. I mean, it was a year course. It became a two-year course shortly after I took it. But regardless, I mean, I've been messing around with electronics since I was a kid, tearing apart old TVs and radios and whatever I get my hands on. There was a video last year sometime, again, I'll put the link up there, about showing my first electronics project kit, which was a lot of fun. But yeah, I've been messing with this stuff forever. Took a course called Telecommunications Technology. Then after that, I worked in broadcast as a technician for a contracting company and directly for radio stations and TV for a bunch of years. And then I got a job working in the telephone industry. Again, it's not... for the same reason I'm not showing the face, I'm not going to tell you who I work for, but I've had contact with, in addition to the direct telephone stuff, both cellular and some landline stuff, microwave radio, DC power systems, more recently a lot of fiber optic stuff, and then all the different trades and contractors surrounding it, so supervising electricians in telephone buildings and HVAC guys and diesel mechanics and all that kind of stuff. So it's a fairly broad base, but now for the guys that want to suggest that I'm an engineer, in my mind, engineers design stuff, technicians fix stuff. And that's more who I think of myself as a technician. I think I've ranted on long enough today. Hope that answers some of your questions, and I'm sure there's going to be more people say, "Oh wait, I have a question," down in the comments. You know the drill. I'll be down there. I'll probably answer some of them. I may save some of them for the next time I do this. I'm not planning on doing this very often. I don't want this to turn into a vlog style channel or anything. But if you have questions or comments, absolutely leave them down below. And I'll try not to rant so much in the future, but you never know what will happen. Thanks for watching. As always, I'll talk to you later.